Hello world and welcome to yet another new episode of Azure Vlog. I hope you are doing fine. I hope you are still healthy. I am, so let's talk about a new preview feature in Azure Sentinel called Watchlist. I can imagine that you have queries where you run detections on all your users or computers or whatever resource you like, but you would like to exclude a couple of users. What you normally do is write down your query and include a where statement, and most likely a where statement where username not in, and then a list of usernames follows. This is a common scenario that I see at a lot of companies, but it results in state in your KQL query. Your KQL query also holds the usernames that are excluded from your detection. And most likely you have a couple of other detections that exclude the same users. So if the users that you would like to exclude changes, a new user is added or a user needs to be removed, you have to do a update of a lot of KQL queries. Aside of good software development practices where you try to exclude as much state as possible in your code, it's really a time-consuming activity to change a lot of queries for changing a list. So what Microsoft did, they invented Watchlist in Azure Sentinel, and that's basically a feature where you can manage lists. Lists of usernames, IP addresses, any values you like, and you can include those lists in your KQL query. So instead of writing all the usernames down in your KQL query, you can reference to that Watchlist, and Azure Sentinel will do its logic over there. So that is really awesome. In this vlog, I would like to explain you how it works. So let's create a cup of espresso coffee and I'll show you how watch lists are working in Azure Sentinel. That was a very good espresso. So enough energy to show you how watchlists work in Azure Sentinel. So as you can see, I'm already in the Azure portal and I have a Azure Sentinel workspace open. And if I go to analytics, I want to show you one rule where I have a exclusion list in. If I click on this rule and click on edit and go to the rule logic, you'll see over here that I have created a rule which will detect changes on Azure Sentinel. It can be suspicious, right, if someone changes your theme. So I have a alert rule set up that will alert me when someone changes my theme, except from these accounts, which is my account and my Sentinel administrator account. So this is typical a query that I see at a lot of customers which hold a certain kind of state in it, the UPNs of the users, and this list changes so now and often. So I think it's not a good idea to have it in the query. And luckily, Microsoft has a watch list available now. So here we are in Azure Sentinel. I went to the menu and clicked on the watch list over here. And it's a vanilla empty environment. So let's create our first watch list. we click on add new, it starts the wizard, and I would like to define a list which holds my Azure Sentinel administrators. So I call it Azure Sentinel administrators, list of Azure Sentinel administrators is a good description, and the alias, this is the thing that we use in Azure Sentinel to query the watch list. I will call it Azure Sentinel admins. So let's click on next. And this is the part of the wizard where we can upload our list. At this moment, only a CSV format with a header is supported. So let me show you the list that I will upload. If I go over here and open my Sentinel administrator CSV file, I have a column that's called username, and I have three users in there. All right, so if I go to browse over here, click on the CSV file, you'll see that it is already parsed over here. It detected the column name and the values that are part of the column. So if we go to next, everything looks good, so we can create our list. So our list has now been created. If I go over to logs, and we can query this list from a KQL query. So if I go over here and I type underscore get watch list, and I need to enter the name of our watch list, or the alias, I must say. We called it Azure Sentinel admins. And I click on run. You'll see that my list is displayed over here. So we can thread this function as a table name. So when I show you the query that was stated in my analytics rule, so we can replace this part of the query where we filter out the users that are excluded from this this detection. Let me show you how I would do that. So the underscore get watch list, we can thread it as table. And that means that it does not work with the contains statement anymore. So we need to use a join for that. So let's start with that join. And the kind that we are going to use is a left ante. So this basically transformed the join statement into some kind of filter. We can make sure that we see all the records that are in Azure Activity, but do not have a match in the watch list. So let's go on. We want to join on the get watch list. I need to define the name of the watch list over here. I called it Azure Sentinel admins. And then I need to configure on what columns I will join this list. So for the left column, I will use the color. That is the name which holds the username in the Azure Activity table. And it should be equals to the right, so the watch list part of the join. And we called it username over there. Remember the CSV that I showed you, the first column was called username, and that was the header. So we can thread that as column name. So if I run this, it will not show us any results. So I'm logged in with my account, and I changed Azure Sentinel on a legal way. So if I change this, for example, to Innerkind, so now it only shows me the records of Azure Activity, which have a match on the username in the Azure Sentinel admins watch list. You'll see that there are records in there, a lot actually. So this is working. Let's change it back to left ante. I will now copy this whole thing. So let's now change our analytics rule so it will work with the watch list that I have created. Let's go to the analytics rule. Let's click on edit.
go to the set logic page and update this whole query for my new created query that uses the watch list. So this is a much cleaner solution. We don't have the usernames in there, and this is much better. It will improve the quality of code. And also the need to change this query has drastically decreased as the list is managed outside of the query. And also what is really interesting is that we can reuse this watch list into other detections. So if you have multiple detections that use the same exclusions, you can define them in one list and reuse that list in all your detections. That's really helpful, I think. So let's save my detection. And then we are done. So if I would now like to update my watch list, currently there is no update mechanism in Azure Sentinel. So what I need to do in order to update the watch list, I need to remove it and recreate it with a changed watch list. So let's update my my watch list. Let's add a new user, sample2@jeroennissen.com. Let's save this one. Let's close it. I will copy the alias because we need that in a minute. I will delete my old rule. Let's now create a new rule. Azure Sentinel administrator. It was called. And I had an alias over here. I will leave the description empty right now. Let's upload the new list. As you can see, sample 2 is in there right now. Let's create it. So if I now go to logs over here, and let me query the watch list, Azure Sentinel admins it was called. Let's run this. You'll see that now my new value has been added. So by adding the new account to my watch list, it automatically now is also part of my analytics rule without changing the query logic. So that is really nice. So in this video, you saw how we can work with watch lists in Azure Sentinel. I demonstrated how we can create a watch list from a CSV file and use it as exclusion for our KQL queries. It is really helpful. It can save you a lot of time if you need to change a lot of queries where that kind of state is in. So make use of this feature. It's really helpful and it's easy to work with. So with that, I would like to close this Azure vlog. So I hope you like this. If so, please hit the thumbs up button. Of course, subscribe to this channel. Ring the notification bell so you know when I upload a new video. And of course, I'll see you in the next one. Bye.